Alright, looks like we're gonna have a Mushroom Kingdom classic here. Dark Peach. Interested to see where they strike to. Surely the Dark will let the Peach go to Dreamland, but other than that, I don't know how this matchup favors. I feel like maybe Pokemon and Yoshis are good for Dark Battlefield. Oh! Immediate callouts. He's got that black skin on too, so you know he's a gangster duck. Oh! Oh, that's unfortunate that he didn't sweet spot there. Oh, took four hits of the down smash. These guys are just definitely throwing out moves real fast, and I feel like the Doc's not taking a lot of time to pause and wait his opponent out and wait. And he's getting punished for it. See, the only time I've seen him ever bait somebody out is when he came back with his fresh stock and he was invincible. Which I guess he's in the habit of doing then, because everyone just runs away from you when you're invincible. But he should do it in neutral. Right now, I'd like to see him take a second and not... Oh, okay, it worked out. It worked out. To be honest, you guys watching this later, I don't know much about this matchup, but I'll just try to comment on the fundamentals that I see. Oh, that's unfortunate. See, right now this Peach just pulling turnips and went too long, so Doc could have just ran up and grabbed. Because the only option Peach had was shield, because he's invincible, so he can't down smash him. Oh, that's like, that worked out. These capes are on point. Definitely, if you can read when these turnips are coming out, then he should be able to convert some stocks. There you go. I like those pullback moves, where the pullback pulls the skirt boxes in so that the Peach is aerial missed. That's a Stitch face, isn't it? Oh, into the gutter. See, the Doc has a lot of callouts. He knows how the game works, and he is understanding the characters, but I feel like he could just use a little bit of research on fundamentals, and if you could put some of those together, then all the other stuff he's doing is great. There, unfortunately, the Doc was giving Peach too much stage, and he's just lucky that she killed herself. Because she had all the room she needed to come back. I also wonder how many times these guys have played this matchup at a competitive level. Because I think Goff of Gaming is way new to the tournament scene. In fact, this may be his first tournament. Because he's hitting the F smashes, and he's hitting the capes, which are like two of the hardest moves to hit. So he knows what's going on, but the Peach just seems to have a bit more experience and out fundamentally him. I assume if they stay the same, or at least this Peach stays Peach, she'll get counterpicked to Yoshi's or Pokemon, but we'll see. looks like they're going Yoshi's, which is a good pick against Peach. But then he switched to Falco, which is definitely a turnaround. And then there's the Marth counter pick. It's quite an interesting counter pick war. I've got to say, if this happened at the top level, it'd be super hype counter picks. Especially out of nowhere. I don't know what these guys' characters these guys have. We'll find out soon. Again, Goff of Gaming is just throwing out attacks whenever he has a chance. Right now seems to be working, but if M catches on to it, then Cap, I should say, if Cap catches on to it, then it's gonna be bad news for Goff. Marth just goes crouched near the edge, threatening the down tilt, I think it's a lot more solid, pretty sure, than charging the game. And again, it all depends on the opponent you're facing, and if you feel like certain things are going to work, you might as well do it and keep working. There's also the angle where if you play super fundamentally, then you don't have to, you know, at this level, read the opponent at all. You just will be able to cover most of what they can do off solid spacing and timing. And knowing when to go in and out. Unfortunate SD. But they're both high stock, high percent of first stock anyway, so it's not that bad. Especially if Falco can get just a strong back air or anything right now. So I'm not sure exactly why. And maybe Shine at that percent would even kill, I'm not sure. But I'm pretty sure Falco has some strong enough moves to instantly KO Marth on the stage that aren't Shine. Oh. No tech on the down throw, and then he gets punished for it. Yeah, see, the Marth is just throwing at attacks after attacks. And in that last situation, when Falco was up on the platform, if this Marth watches later and wants to rewind, he could have just jumped towards him and not said anything. He's got a lot to learn. It's his first tournament, so there's so much to this game. It goes so deep. I've been playing for about a year now, and I don't even know. There's so much more to learn. I've always wondered how good the up smash on Yoshi's platform is as a tech chase, because if they don't get up attack, I think you can kind of cover all the angles, but I just don't know if it's the best follow-ups, especially when you could do a fall-through up air or other kinds of launchers, for sure. Or even a grab. Marth's grab is so good. Anyway, it looks like the Marth's using the stage to his advantage right now, so... Oh! That could have been bad. Now see there, he just keeps jumping forward with aerials, which... He's lucky they're hitting, because all that the Falco would need to do is just dash back before going in. And then the move would come out, and it's a free punish. You can get a 50% punish easily. That was good, though. Let's see if the Falco can pick it up this last stock and call Goff of Gaming out for being a little too aggressive here. Let's see. Yeah, his punishes aren't bad. Not bad at all. See? Well, he threw out a short hop and then a double jump back air. If he just did the double jump without throwing on the back air, he could have come down with the down air and he would have got Marth in a bad situation. But again, it's a lot of just throwing out moves as fast as possible. That's solid stuff. That'll be it. Cap will take the set. 2-0.